Hey everyone, welcome to the Playback Podcast presented by Carr, your weekly podcast featuring America's favorite dancers, hosted by America's favorite road warriors. We are your hosts, Jocelyn and Kristen. And as you guys can see, Madison is not here with us this week. We are actually officially announcing that Madison is taking a step back away from the podcast, but don't worry, it's all for good, positive reasons. She is a pageant coach across the country. She has her Madison Curtis coaching program and it's doing very well. She's starting to hire people under her. So really, she's just growing that business and really focusing on the pageant circuit. I know we have a lot of dancers across the country that are also pageant kids, and some of you guys are Madison's clients, but if you're interested, definitely reach out to Madison Curtis Coaching. She's incredible. She's building an awesome team around her. And she's really, you know, just influencing these young girls in the best way. Obviously, we love her and we support her. And we're going to miss her, but we're excited for this new phase. I guess this officially kicks off season two. So
season two of the pod.
Whoa. So we're just excited. We've got a lot of fun stuff.
We're excited
planned.
To be here.
Yes.
Really?
Yeah. We obviously just wrapped up finals. So this is going to be our finals recap video. And, you know, we had multiple finals and obviously we couldn't be everywhere all at once. So we'll kind of pop in here and there, just going over the incredible talent we've seen this season. And then
we're going to kind of be all over the place.
We'll be all over the place. Just kind of popcorn around talking about where we were at. Nate and I were in Anaheim. She was at both of the Pigeon Forge cars. And then Nate obviously popped over to every single one. So
I only missed Pigeon One.
Yes.
Yeah.
I couldn't be two places at once, but I need to show them all up.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. So that's what we're going to do. Our best to do today is just really give everybody some love, the recognition on an amazing season. And if we missed you, I'm sorry. We love you. And I'm sure we'll talk about you next season.
And if we miss you, we're going to get you in this off season. Like,
yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
New content and stuff like that.
For sure.
It was truly a great season, honestly.
I feel like every season gets better and better.
Yes.
No, like it really was. It really was. I feel like every season I get more fired up. And I don't know if it's because you start to develop the relationship with these kids and teachers.
Oh,
and
yeah.
You really get to see them grow. I feel like that's probably my personal favorite thing. But it's just, it's been fun. And we really do appreciate you guys continuing to listen. We honestly, I know from Nate's perspective and us, when we were in Anaheim, and even you said this too, I feel like we didn't realize, you know, people actually fully like we're looking forward to our episodes every week. So
it's kind of crazy.
Yeah. And so we're just excited to continue to do this. Obviously, we love dance. We love talking with you guys. And it was really fun to get to meet a bunch of you guys over the finals weeks.
I'm going Annie first overall.
Uh-huh.
She nailed her performance. Like when it counted, she won during competition, but during title night, Maddie Stone, she won, and they flip-flopped each other.
Yeah.
And both of them, as much as we see them, they are always on. But I did know in the moment during competition, Annie got this, and I did know in title, Maddie got this. Right into signatures in this shirt.
Oh, stunning.
Guys.
They're undefeated, I believe. So I don't think they've lost at all this season. And that just...
And when at Anaheim, we had two competitions. The way it was like two huge finals. And we all ate together, both staffs. And when we were in the lunchroom, everyone talking about in this shirt.
Yeah.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Everyone like, people trying to get people to cover them to take a break from.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure like judges came down during their off hours.
But Ryan, how did you think of that? Like, and all the things they do on it, like the ponche on the side of the couch, like,
can
how
I tell
are you,
you
like, you know, just get up there.
The funniest story.
Tell us.
So last year, my intermediate small group, the one with the bench, we choreographed that like a month before nationals, and we were like, let's just be silly, let's be goofy, let's just like take it to nationals. So we did, and it ended up winning, which was amazing. But my plan was to take that one into the new season, but because they won, we couldn't compete it.
Yeah.
So I started from scratch, and it was December, it was our winter show. I had a completely different song, everything. I still had a couch, and I saw it on stage, and I was like, I actually don't like this at all, and this is not as good as the one that we did in Vegas. So I ended up re-choreographing the entire thing, new song, new concept, new everything, the end of December. I called the girls in and I was like, we're going to come into the studio on a Sunday for like 6 hours. I need you here. We're going to do it. And that's where In the Shirt came about. But it was from August to December. It was a completely different dance. Different song, different everything. And I'm so glad that I did.
Yeah, it worked out amazing for you guys.
That dance is so good.
Congrats to Ryan. She got the Antoine Olds Award. And if you guys come to our competitions, you guys know at Showcase, we give a special award for one of our judges who is huge in the dance industry with choreographing and judging for us. And we like to honor his type of choreography style, just taking risks, doing cutting edge stuff that really, you know, is something that is going to touch that audience. So they won that Antoine Olds Award for just, you know, a beautiful, beautiful job. It was stunning. And I think that dance is one of my favorite of all time. Like, I don't think that 3 seasons from now, we're still going to be talking about it.
Oh, absolutely.
It. And I do feel like all those dancers in that group, like Mariah, everyone at Signature, obviously their training comes into it, but I feel like they complement each other and they dance so well together. And I feel like, yeah, technically Annie was, you know, the main dancer of that routine, but every single one of them were so committed to it. You almost forget to breathe when you're watching it because it's just so incredible and so beautifully done. So anyway, we could talk about that routine.
Yeah. I know. We could keep going
all day because, wow. Because
we said popcorn.
We said popcorn. We said we're doing speed round.
And then it was like 15 minutes later.
From now on, speed round.
Popcorn.
All right,
okay,
let's go.
Nurka.
Okay, Pigeon Forge 1. I got to see Dance Attack. I haven't seen Dance Attack in a few years.
Florida.
Yeah. Okay. Florida studio. They're incredible. I think they're just built different down there. They train different there. I don't know what it is, but they had this small group, elite small group, 15 to 19. They ended up winning in Star Showcase. Pas de Regret. Bomb. They were clowns. Beautiful, like fluid lines throughout the entire thing. It was kind of funny-ish. They had this balloon on a stick. And at the end, the guy finally got it. The main dancer in it. He finally got it and he was so excited about it. And then one of the girls pops it. And they all start laughing at him and he's crying. And just like the way it was executed, like I want to kind of like know how their rehearsals went with that. Because they all were so in tune with each other. And well done because they won.
Yeah.
It was incredible. I was so excited to see it again.
Popcorn.
Are you just going to yell popcorn?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm down. I'm down. Okay. I'm going to talk about Forever Dance Lake Tahoe. We actually interviewed them. So if you guys were in Anaheim, Nate and I kind of set up our own little podcast area and I was working MC. So I could only come in and out as often as I could, but we did get the chance to interview Dino.
Fun fact, that was not planned.
It was not planned.
The stage, they broke down the stage because we didn't need it anymore. Adrian's like, hey, should I have them leave this stage up? Like, for what?
Yeah.
I was in Pigeon Forge seeing all the posts like, I wish I was there.
But if you guys liked us being there, that'd be really cool if we could stop by all of the finals next year. Well, this upcoming season.
Yeah.
So anyway, we'll put in all those interview clips from all the people that we got to talk to. And if we didn't get the chance to talk to you, again, it wasn't planned. It was kind of a spur of the moment thing. Mm. We grabbed people when we could. So,
and keep in mind, we both were doing normal roles.
Yeah. We were both there working. And then like, I would get off a shift and then I would go on. Like it was crazy, and but it was so much fun.
It would have to be a time that I was available. And like, there's literally 2 huge competitions with multiple. It was weird.
Yeah.
It was very hard. So, if we didn't get to you, it was literally because we just couldn't.
Yeah.
We wanted to talk to everyone.
Yeah. And we wanted to talk to the showcase winners, but like we're only there for a certain amount of hours. So the house people started tearing down stages and everything. Like it was out of our control.
Literally.
It was out of our control. But Forever Dance Lake Tahoe, Dino, and just these incredible dancers overall, not only did they take home production and Superline, so they got to reperform both of those in the showcase, but they also took home some showcase wins as well. Their quality of just overall production, like I said, the costumes, their choreographer, obviously, but more importantly, like their commitment to characters was absolutely insane. Their
Gladiator,
Beetlejuice, their production, everything was so, you know, musical theater-esque that I almost felt like I was paying to watch a show in New York. It was so well done. So
they got good, passionate dancers.
Passionate, yes. And I will say, and I did talk about this when we interviewed them, but their prop dad, main guy, and just their entire prop team.
We always give the seniors our leads, and then we wrap our brain around that. And once we know that we can match the leads with all of our seniors. We figure out what's going to be best for our production, and then put the music together. And then Branna's dad is our lead prop dad and helps us build all of our props.
Let's give it up for her dad really quick.
That was like
so
a
him,
movie.
Him as well as a big crew, we got to take some family. But,
you can tell. And is your dad the one that always comes out and cleans up every tiny little feather? Because I love that man.
Yeah.
Hannah Colin, she did beautiful job on her solo, Gold, which choreographed by Gianna. The York Sisters, amazing.
Oh, yes, from Tenacity.
Yeah.
So, so good.
Yeah.
So you guys might remember, I talked about a Shrek dance, What's Up, Duloc, earlier on in the season. I talked about how I wanted to see a production. I was like, dang, I hope someone does a production to it. What do you know? Pigeon Forge 1, someone does a production to What's Up, Duloc. And it was brilliant, you guys. Literally.
No, it's so good. It's so good.
Like, she laughs because she's seen it. And the like main girl who was Lord Farquaad was hilarious, did the job. Had like her costume had the little legs, and she danced on her knees the whole time with those little legs and
the commitment. Yeah. So good. It's really good. I wish I was in it.
I know, me too.
I wish I was in it.
Like, I really do.
Like, Jocelyn could be Lord Farquaad in that routine.
Call me.
Popcorn.
I'm going to go with Define Dance.
Bag Lady.
Okay.
Sure.
So,
called it.
So, this performance choreographed by Raven from Define Dance Space. Absolutely insane. If you guys know their style, it's so different. I feel like they can walk out on stage and I know if it's from their studio just based on the way that their dancers carry themselves.
Oh, yeah.
Like 1,000%. But they
look tough.
They look tough, but there's like such a cool little vibe to them. I love it. So this performance, they had all like these lime green purses and it was called Bag Lady. And they all like immediately from the start just come and grab. And their prop usage is so good and so stylized. But it was just one of those routines. Again, I was like, I want to be in this. I want to be in this routine. I was like, so I felt jaded that I wasn't allowed to be in it. So I just, the fact that also it did win the Antoine Olds Choreography Award, just because it was just, I feel like everyone was, again, talking about that one. Even judges were talking about it in the break room. Like, that was just so different. So I'm going to be curious to see if there's like, not, I'm going to say like, copycats, but like if that inspires other choreography for this upcoming season, because I feel like that style, number one, I feel like goes, oh yeah, we said we were popcorning.
Jordan Center Dance, Killer Queen won a star showcase. They just brought a different kind of intensity from what I saw at regionals. Like, there was something different about their performance when they performed at Star Showcase versus when I saw them at regionals, because I didn't get to see them perform during the regular portion of competition at finals, but I got to see it again at Star Showcase, and the judges were loving it. Like, it's the way that they talked about it after Star Showcase. They were like, dang, that Killer Queen dance, like, that was really intense in the best way possible.
Yeah.
Did you said Forge, popcorn. Smooth Criminal?
Oh, so good. Nate and Jocelyn both got to see it already and they were hyping it up. I saw a video, but the video doesn't do it justice. Oh, I don't think. It's the way that they walked out on stage and hit that first pose before the music even started that I got so fired up. I was like, this is already good. I feel like they train so different there. Like, everything at the Element is so staccato and together at all moments. You do not see one dancer, like, if their arms are here, all of their arms are here. It's not there. You know, does that make sense?
Popcorn. All right, I'm gonna go with popcorn. I'm gonna go with Lana's. They
Lana's.
Did amazing this season. They
French
took
twist.
Home, yes, the French twist. So iconic. I love it. They did amazing. They actually ended up winning the novice level. So they got to re-perform at Star Showcase
for Choo Choo Chibugi, which was a really cute little tap routine. But then another one of their taps took home a showcase as well. It was Ready Teddy, super cute routine, fun, energetic. But I have to talk about their senior group they did when we were young, and it was such a beautiful routine. I may have shed a tear or two.
Shocker.
Yeah, but it was just so beautifully done, and you could tell that every single, especially at a Star Showcase, like every performance has led up to this moment, mm-hmm. and you could tell that every single one of those dancers, they were in it 120%, and they really were dancing together, and like the connections, they were looking at each other on stage, and like I could tell they were looking out, and you can see, especially if you know you're one of those choreographers that stands right in front of our video camera, like up in front of our video setup, like they can see you. So I saw that connection, and I was just watching it, and I was crying, and I could see everyone else was crying, and they just did such a beautiful job, and they're always just so nice to have at a competition in general. So just congratulations to Lana and Layla and everyone at that studio. You guys did a beautiful job, and you did amazing this competition season, so you should be so proud.
Speaking of crying, the Pigeon Forge, I like the way you tell it.
Oh yes, yes, yes. The girl that did the Dancers Against Cancer Judges Review video, mm-hmm. for her solo,
oh my
for the
gosh, that soloist, one. Her dad I think had a heart attack, right, and was in the hospital, and her solo was essentially like dedicated to him, kind of a spoken word situation.
I received a text from my mom while I was at practice. Please call me if you get a break. That's when I felt it. That feeling when you know something is wrong.
Just before the segment started, the dad, he ran up to me in the front and said, like, hey, I want to donate for the DAC to get the video that you're going to shoot. And I'm like, it literally was starting. Like, oh, no, go to merch, go to merch. And he's like, okay. And so that this was the act. So at the end of the dance, she, the dancer, because I'm looking at the dancer, but Nurka's back there with the parents.
Yeah, I was at the tally table. Our photographer was right next to us. The parents were right there, and I could like hear them like sniffling, and I looked behind, full sobbing, full like holding each other, sobbing. And she like did this wave
at the end
to her dad at the end. And
and then she started crying on stage.
Oh my God.
Everybody just was crying.
Oh yeah.
We couldn't have like planned this out with actors better.
Oh yeah. Like I could have sworn I saw a tear fall from Nate's eyes.
Ooh, I know. Brooke Phillips.
Oh, from, yeah. Stars Elite?
From Stars Elite. I mean, I got to see her in Fort Mill for one of the regionals.
Oh.
Her and, I mean, they're so insanely good there. Like, but I feel like Brooke, she walks on stage and I feel like you use the analogy of like moving through water. Like, I feel like she's almost in slow motion. And I feel like everything is so like finished from her fingertip to her toes. It's so just isolated. Mm-hmm. Would that be the word you'd use?
Yeah.
But it's just, she's stunning. And I feel like she did her first routine and I was like, oh wow, like beautiful. Okay, she won. And then she came out with her second one and I was like,
like, how do you get better?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly that. I was like, oh my gosh. So yeah. She's just so good. And, you know, Stars Elite in general, like Maggie's there as well, Maggie Cheryl, and she's one of our car proteges. So yeah. They've got some incredibly talented dancers over there. Awesome job.
That's where Madeline Underwood came from.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Literally, like, you just think in North Carolina.
Yeah.
Just pumping out Megan Botsford, pumping out these crazy dancers.
Like, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's brilliant.
Awesome.
Speaking of dancers that, like, it looks like they're, like, flowing through water, Lauren Martin from the Element Dance Center. I haven't seen the Element all season. Finally got to see them. Her solo was brilliant too. At last. It was in this like beautiful blue costume. She ended up winning Miss Dance. And apparently she won Miss Teen last year.
That's awesome.
And then she aged up and won Miss Dance. And the judges were saying afterwards, after they saw her performance during the normal portion of competition, they were like, there's just something else that she brings to the stage that none of her competitors were bringing. And it was like that grace and that like elevated, I love dance without like actually being like, I love dance on stage,
no,
you know?
So so beautiful. We were talking about that. Like you said, there's just that something extra that obviously there's incredibly talented kids, especially at our national finals. Like clearly that's the best of the best. They've been winning all season long, but now they're coming to compete against each other. And like you were saying, Annie and Madeline, they're just so good, but
each one of them on different days brought that extra something. Not that they didn't execute it flawlessly, but it's just sometimes the dancer has that special moment on stage and it resonates with that audience, and that's what brings home the win.
If you were going to create a player and it was a dance video game, you would literally build your dancer like Lauren.
Oh, like, absolutely.
You know what I mean?
You can
on
see,
top of everything yes. else, she's literally throws her legs.
Okay, I want to talk about, speaking of like beautiful tears, all that good stuff from Cutting
We're
Edge.
We're just crying a lot.
We're just crying. Guys, long season. We know you guys work hard. So I feel like that's what I'm talking about. That's my favorite part. When you see the dancers like work hard all season long, yeah. and then you get there and you're like, you guys really did it. And like,
yeah.
especially Patrice and Kiana and Jacob and everyone at Cutting Edge, like you could tell that they came to compete this year,
oh,
but
absolutely.
Not even just about the trophy, just like they came to dance for themselves. That beautiful umbrella routine to that Adele Easy On Me song. And it was just like, when I tell you, I was crying. And like, it was so, so good. And Miranda, the main girl, like her technique obviously
brilliant.
Is brilliant, but like her emotion and all those kids. And again, I'm a sucker for watching the choreographer. I feel like, okay, I'm going to use this analogy. You know, when you're at a wedding, But you know, when you're at a wedding and you, instead of watching the bride walk down the aisle, you like to watch the groom react to the bride walking down the aisle. I would say that's the equivalent of.
Are you good?
Popcorn. Go.
Jocelyn talked about this soloist earlier on in the season from Extravaganza and Tumble. She had a tap solo to Unwritten. It was so beautiful. For some reason, it did not click in my head that you had already talked about this soloist. And then I saw her live. Mm-hmm. Brilliant. Her tap
so
sounds
good.
Immaculate.
Yeah.
She brought this joy to the stage, kind of like Lauren Martin does when she dances on stage. And you could just tell that she loves everything that she does. Even in the group routines, too.
Yes.
She gave off that air of like, yes. wow, this is the best. And I was like, I agree. This mm-hmm. is the best. I really liked her.
While we're on the topic of Extravadance. Mm-hmm. So in Pigeon Forge, we had Extravadance and Tumble there. And we also had Creative Dance. And both of
yes.
those studios did huge DAC fundraisers. They're big, big Hope studios. They come back every single year. They take it really, really seriously. But both of them donated separately a little over like $17,000 to Dancers Against Cancer. Both of them individually. So it was
Insanity.
Absolutely... I mean, obviously just so generous, but just the fact that, like you were saying, they're Hope Studios and they're coming out and they're competing, but it's cool that they're able to add a national finals, then show their dance community how they're giving back. And it was just a special moment. I unfortunately wasn't there, but it was just an awesome, awesome.
It was a beautiful moment to like celebrate them celebrating and raising awareness and hope for DAC.
Yeah, it was awesome. So thank you guys so much. I did just want to go ahead and give a shout out. If you guys even just bought any merch at finals, that was DAC. Thank you for your donations. But we did something really cool. We did it last season. We tested it out and you guys really liked it. So we incorporated it this year as well. Nate was generous with his time and his editing skills to do those DAC Judges View videos. So essentially you're getting that up close, like he said, on that gimbal, you're getting that amazing content. And yes, it's for social media, but more importantly, you're helping support DAC. And he did a beautiful job and we're going to obviously post those. And we've posted a couple of them, but we're going to continue to do so just to say thank you for your support. But also they were just so beautiful. And he obviously kind of jumped to every single finals that he could in order to do those. But we're excited that Ansel now, who was one of our videographers this year, he did some social media stuff and he was at Hollywood Dance Experience with us. He is absolutely incredible. So we're hoping to incorporate him into that next year. And that way we can kind of across the board get more DAC Judges View videos out there because you guys love them. And obviously it's supporting us as well. So just thank you, Nate. Those turned out awesome.
Yeah,
and that was Nate's idea, too. Last year, he came up with that idea. And I feel like it's been really amazing.
Yeah, thanks. Thank you. I love it. I figure all these beautiful dancers, they do such a good job. And you know what I mean? It's just, you could see the details in their face and everything.
Oh,
like
absolutely.
That. And thank God for the dad who bought the video. Like I said, think about that moment.
Mm-hmm. Like now they have that forever.
They have it. Like right there, you could see her crying. Like you could see the moment she sees them. Like,
yeah.
Oh, it's.
It's an intimate moment. And I feel like it's such a personal connection, and the clarity and everything about it. Yeah. You really feel like you're watching that dancer because he's moving with them. So.
And I encourage, like, if you ever do, like, or if you ever do donate and get that video, to don't try to ignore the fact that the camera's there. Like, embrace that it's there.
Like we're talking about camera work and everything like that. Like that's your moment, because you can do an entire dance, and if a camera's following you, but you don't make that connection, you feel like you're watching something from the outside. But if you're looking into a lens, you feel connected. You feel like you're there in real time watching that performance. So just might as well take advantage, especially, since we're going to have him and hopefully Ansel, just so that we can offer it to more people and give more opportunities. But it's a beautiful thing. And I'm excited that we were able to, you know, help fundraise.
Popcorn.
Triple Threat. We've talked about them all
season.
They really brought their A game to Nationals. I really enjoyed that I got the opportunity to finally see them, because that was the first time I got to see them.
I haven't seen them at all.
They had quite a few routines make it into our star showcase. A couple that I wanted to point out are Dirty Diana and The Jam. I'm pretty sure The Jam was their undefeated routine. Like those girls
five-time grand champions.
Yeah, yes. Like it's like a whole thing. So congrats to them. Dirty Diana, bomb. You've got Ryan Amato in the center just killing it. And funny thing about Dirty Diana at Star Showcase, they were wearing like almost like Doc Martin boots. And one of the girls literally danced out of the bottom of her shoe. Like, you know, that like bottom, like gummy part, like totally danced out of it and just kept going. And they ended up winning. This part of it like came off. The fact that they can be that professional and dance through that and still crush it and like not draw attention to that.
I love seeing how they get out of that predicament. Like,
is
someone going to kick
it?
So cool. Is someone going to like do an illusion and grab it?
Yeah.
Grab it. Someone does. And I like give them a little wink. I'm like, nice one.
Like, I saw you.
Yeah.
Pacific blue. Arts Complex blue. Loved
blue.
It.
Blue.
Like simple blue.
So good.
Everything
was
blue.
But it was the song. I'm blue. Da, ba, dee, da, da. Mm-hmm. Honestly, if I'm being real, I wouldn't hear that song and be like, ooh, I envision a really cool routine to this.
No, that's why.
And that's why it was so different, because they were somehow pulling off like this funny, weird song that we all know. But it was so cool.
It was so cool.
And they had such like a different vibe than you would expect for that song.
Yeah.
It was so good. They're good.
OCPA,
I was impressed by them.
Good.
And Berlin was there too. She ended up coming. She didn't compete, but she was there. We got an interview with her and Addie, who's one of their choreographers.
Well, this year I've been working with her for so long. So it's pretty easy now. We have it down to a system. I pretty much go like this, hey, can you do this? And she's like, I don't know. And I was like, well, let's try. And then pretty much if it works, it works. If not, she almost breaks her neck. And I go, oh, it's probably not the one for us. Let's
readjust. Something else comes out of it.
Yeah.
Or something else comes out of it. I go, hey, wait, that actually looks good. Let's try it again.
Yeah.
And if she can duplicate it, then we're like, okay, that goes in.
Is it fun working with a dancer like Berlin, who can kind of do, I mean, just about anything?
Absolutely. It's like a teacher's dream.
Yeah, that's cool.
Literally.
Do you turn?
I do turn.
All right.
Do you like to choreograph Berlin?
Sometimes, like when I'm by myself, but like, not there yet.
Do you enjoy improv, or are you like a set choreography person?
Oh, yeah, I do enjoy improv.
Inspired Dance Complex and Zach Falk is just absolutely insane. But the Out of the Woods, they won Showcase. You can see it all season long, but when they make it into that Star Showcase and they're competing,
it brings out
something different, that energy. And like the part I'm talking about where they like charge the front of the stage. Yeah. Like all of us were so into it.
Also in Myrtle Beach, I haven't been to a Long Island show in a long time. And I was so happy to see RSDA, Jenna Lee, she did a great job. I hadn't seen her in so long. God, last time I seen her at a competition, she was like a little nugget. Yeah. Their studio is just so good. They have so many cool. They had like Donda.
Oh, right? Yes, I did see that one. Yeah. That was good.
Jenny Lee used to be, this is like a weird fact, but she used to be the like photo on our pin envelopes.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I remember when I was like pinning stuff last year. Yeah, she was on there.
Yeah.
Getting crowned.
Now that you say that, yes, yeah. I can picture it.
This whole offseason, we're going to be mixing in so much finals content from this past final from all of them. So it's been so hard with so much stuff going on this last month to kind of get to kind of showcase all the dances that deserve the recognition. And we're definitely going to begin that process. So don't you worry.
Don't you worry.
And if we missed you. Yeah. Dang it. But if we missed you and you obviously were like a star showcase winner or a title winner or something, like let us know, because again, we were, you know, we can only remember so much off the top of our heads. And these are just the ones that like I haven't stopped talking about to them and, you know, everyone else in our company. But we, I'm sure, skipped over some talented kids. And I just, you know, we're doing our best. And we'll definitely, you know, do little things here and there, even if we didn't get a chat with you or talk about you. Even
hit us up on social
media. Let us know. We'll post you on stories or just something to give you the love and recognition that you deserve, because we just had an awesome season this year.
Yeah.
I feel like every year the kids just keep getting better and better. You're talking about it, you know, with OCPAA and everything. The kids younger and younger and younger are just getting down these skills that are just absolutely amazing. So, you know, we want to do you guys justice and really give you the recognition, you, the dancers, and you, the teachers and choreographers as well. So
we're very excited because this is technically the first episode of season two of Playback Podcast. And now we can bring on some guests.
Yeah.
We're very excited about that. We're actually going to start that next week.
Yep. It'll be good. It'll be good. So as always, thank you guys for listening. We're excited for a new season of dance and convention and comps and obviously following all things dance here. We'll be chatting it up, getting some good guest choreographers, guest road warriors. If you guys are interested in learning more about like judges or anything like that, we've got so much access to all these incredible people. So we're excited to start a new season. Chatting with you guys. As always, thank you guys for listening. Make sure you're following us on all of the things on social media. Dance Car, DAC, Rainbow, Ultra, the list goes on and on. Hollywood Dance Experience. And again, we just thank you guys for listening, and we'll see you on the road.